In today's lesson, we are going to solve an investment problem. Let us solve this problem. John invested $25,000. He invested part of it at 6% and the rest at 8% per year. How much did he invest at each rate if, after 1 year, the total interest earned was $1,800? So, according to the problem, the total amount invested by John was $25,000. Part of it was invested at 6%. And the rest at 8%. The total interest earned for 1 year was 1,800. Let us represent by X the amount invested at 6%. So if we subtract this amount represented by X from $25,000, we get the amount invested at 8%. So 25,000 minus X, this is the amount invested at 8%. Principal times rate times time is equal to interest. This is the amount invested at 6%. It's represented by X. And the rate is 6%. 0.06 is the decimal equivalent of 6%. And the time is 1 year. 0.06 times X times 1 is equal to 0.06X. And then 25,000 minus X, this is the amount invested at 8%. The decimal equivalent of 8% is 0.08. This is also 1 because this amount was also invested at here, 1 year. So we multiply 25,000 minus X by 0.08 and then by 1, we get 0.08 times the quantity 25,000 minus X. Let us form this equation. 0.06X plus 0.08 times the quantity 25,000 minus X is equal to the total interest earned for 1 year, which was $1,800. We have now 0.06x plus 0.08 times the quantity 25,000 minus x is equal to 1,800. Let us solve for x. It is easier to solve for X if we can convert this coefficient of X, which is a decimal number, this 0.06, to an integer. And then this 0.08 to an integer, it will be easy to solve for X. 0.06 is equal to 6 over 100 and 0.08 is equal to 8 over 100. 0.06 times 100 is equal to 6 and 0.08 times 100 is equal to 8. Let us multiply the left side of this equation by 100 and the right side by 100. So 100 times 0.06x is equal to 6x. And 0.08 times the quantity 25,000 minus x times 100 is equal to plus 8 times the quantity 25,000 minus x. And then 1,800 times 100 is equal to 180,000. Let us apply the distributive property of multiplication here. So we have now 6x plus 8 times 25,000 and then 8 times negative x. So we have plus 200,000 minus 8x is equal to 180,000. 6x and negative 8x are like terms, so we can combine them. 6x negative 8x is equal to negative 2x. And then we transpose 200,000 to the right side of the equation. We change its sign from positive to negative. So we have now 180,000 minus 200,000. 180,000 negative 200,000 is equal to negative 20,000. So we have now negative 2x is equal to negative 20,000. We divide both sides by negative 2. Divided by negative 2. Negative 2x divided by negative 2 is equal to x. And negative 20,000 divided by negative 2 is equal to 10,000. So x is equal to $10,000. This is the amount invested at 6%. 25,000 minus x. X is now equal to 10,000. So 25,000 minus 10,000 is equal to 15,000. So $15,000 is the amount invested at 8%.